Already keynote speakers and moderator have presented about the grid transformation technology. So how the grid transformation has happened in the world, we have seen from there. So as in the context of Nepal, we are just starting that grid transformation in the field of renewable energy. It's a solar energy, and it is in maybe EV charging penetration. So that's why there are only a few more slides to tell about the grid transformation in Nepal. Besides that, I would like to introduce this electricity scenario, energy scenario of Nepal initially. So I would like to introduce, this is the introduction to Nepal. This is the geographical map and all this data you can see. So energy sector, generally in Nepal, traditional, commercial, and renewable, three types of energy are used. And in 2009-2010, it was 80% coverage with biomass traditional types, but now it is reduced by 69%. It is around 15% we reduced by the renewable ones. So we can see in the graph also the trend of all these traditional, commercial, and renewables. Traditional is reducing, whereas the renewables is going somewhere. So this is the electric sector overview. So in Nepal, these are the government of Nepal, Ministry of Energy, Water and Resources is looking for the policy. And the Nepal Electricity Authority is the only one utilities that is doing business for generation, transmission, and distribution. All in all, that's the monopoly system. But few, maybe around 15 years ago, it was started, some generation companies are there to provide electricity to the NEA. And this is the status, grid connectivity. Around 78% of the peoples are connected with the grid system. And our system is totally a hydro-dominated systems. We have around 1,300 megawatt of installed capacity. And among that, only 55 megawatt is from thermal. And few megawatts, I'll tell you in coming slides, maybe 8 or 10 megawatts from solar energy, maybe. And this is the electrification status. We have 7 provincial areas, and around 70% of the household has coverage of electricity. And the government of Nepal has planned to complete all electrification within 2022, within 3 years from now. So we are planned to finish all households to be with electricity. That is maybe the solar in there. That is there may be isolated as well as the grid connected. That's the target of the government. So this is the energy availability. From energy availability, energy utilization in 2010 and year 2025. This is the comparison. So most of the energy are used by the residential consumers. Industrial commercial consumers are less in numbers, maybe around 90 to 95% from the industrial sectors. 87% it was in 2010, whereas in 2015 it is 80%. So this time we are importing in an average around 37 to 38% of electricity from India by using the Muzaffarpur Dalgebar transmission line. And in the coming year, but we have a capacity of 1400 megawatt installed capacity, but in the coming year it will be a 3000, and in the next 2 years it will be a more than 5000 megawatts. So we are improving the hydropower construction are in processes. So either that energy has to be consumed within the Nepal, or we have to deliver it to evacuate it to the India. So great transformation opportunity. Current alternative energy scenario in Nepal show 36 megawatt of electricity generation by micro and small hydropowers. See this number of households, solar rooftops, and Nepal government has make policy to have the rooftop solar to penetrate into our grid systems, and we are paying if they are delivering more energy to us and grid energy is less, then net metering facilities has been provided to them. So this, the 33,000 of such type of households are using solar rooftops, and 23.5 megawatt electricity generated by solar and wind as alternative energy sources till now, and 3,414 biogas plants and 1,100 improved water mills. So grid challenges. This is intermittent nature of renewable energy, inadequate grid size, small grid size, and insufficient data. So we are just in the initial stage of the system. So we started it, but so current status of electric vehicles in Nepal. EVs started in Nepal in 1975 by electric trolley bus, but it was not working these days. In 1993, battery-powered Shafar Tempo was operated in Kathmandu Valley itself. And in 2010, Riva and Eva was introduced. And in 2009, few public bus was launched in Kathmandu. They are using in ring roads of the Kathmandu Valley. So the government has good supports and policy. Just like 14 and 23% of taxes imposed for public and private EVs, whereas for 261 of fossil fuels for four-wheelers, those petroleum products, these vehicles are taxed by 261%. So that is from generally most of the vehicles we are purchased from India itself, and other international countries also too. Zero road tax for EVs. So a total of 700 Shafar Tempos are present till date with 7 manufacturing companies and 38 charging stations. And Shafar Tempo growth declined during the load shedding period. Post load shedding, ERA has received the market and the growth prospectus for EVs are high. I think most of you know about the load shedding status of Nepal. It was around 16 hours, maybe 3 years ago. 3 or 4 years ago, it was the case. But now, after the synchronization of Indian and Nepalese power by Dalkebar Muzaffarpur line, it was eliminated. And we don't have such kind of load shedding problem now. And presently, 10% sales in private vehicles are contributed from EVs. Tax, yes, it's finished. Tax exempted, but lastly, I can say the electricity mobility development barriers with policy and governments from the government sides, infrastructure and markets, financing conditions for the EVs, and data monitoring. These are the barriers, and government is trying to make easy for these barriers in the coming days. So for the grid transformation needs, EV penetration, RE integration, industrial and commercial development. In the EV penetration, Nepal, which has just recovered from load shedding, we are preparing for EV boom in the coming decade because we have hydro energy. It's a good to use all EVs with hydro energy. Clean energy is there. Carbon footprint will be reduced. So the trade deficit between Nepal and India in terms of petroleum products, we are transporting all these from India. So that can be reduced by the use of EVs. And urban and rural pollution. The pollution is, that's a huge pollution in Kathmandu. That can be reduced by the use of EV. And future prospectus, metering policy. We have made the metering policy for the solar rooftops and net metering. And NEA is also upgrading, strengthening its all infrastructures, including all the capacity of substations, as well as the transmission line and the distribution lines within the valleys. And NEA is also planning to have 50 electric charging stations as a subsidy to the private and public sectors for the whole of the countries as a sample project. This is the scenario. Thank you.